Question is, which is a common passage in swallowing food and breathing? Our options being A. Larynx, B. Gullet, C. Glottis, and D. Pharynx. So the pharynx is a part of our body, the respiratory and the digestive system, which allows passage of both food and air, and it shows presence of an epiglottis. Near the entry point to avoid entry of food in the air pipe. So the first answer is. So our second question is, the gas exchange surface in an earthworm is, our options being A. Trachea, B. Gills, C. Skin, and D. Tenidia. So different types of structures are provided in different organisms for gas exchange. For example, we have gills in aquatic animals or fishes. We have lungs in vertebrates like man or human beings. Trachea are structures used for respiration in insects, some insects. And similarly, the skin performs a function of gas exchange in an earthworm. So our answer is option number 6. Third question is, what is vital capacity of our lungs? Option A, inspiratory reserve volume plus expiratory reserve volume. Option B, total lung capacity minus residual volume. Option C, inspiratory reserve volume plus tidal volume. Option D, total lung capacity minus expiratory reserve volume. So here we need to remember one thing, that the vital capacity essentially is the total volume plus the inspiratory reserve volume plus the expiratory reserve volume. However, this can also be represented as the total volume, lung capacity, or the total of lungs minus the reserve volume. This can also be written as lung capacity or total lung capacity is equal to vital capacity plus the reserve volume. So here the answer is option B. So our fourth question is, the largest quantity of air that can be expired after a maximum inspiratory effort is, option A, residual volume, option B, tidal volume, option C, vital capacity of lung, option D, lung volume. So here the answer is quite straightforward, as the vital capacity of the lung is the quantity of air that can be expired after a maximum inspiratory effort. However, we should also realize what the residual volume is. The residual volume is the volume of air remaining in the lungs even after a forcible expiration, which is approximately 1100 to 1200 ml. The tidal volume is the volume of air inspired or expired during a normal respiration, which ranges from around 600 to 800 for a healthy human being. And the lung volume is the capacity of the lung. So answer of this question is option C. So our next question is, the partial pressure of oxygen in the alveolar air is, option A, 45 mm of Hg, option B, 95 mm of Hg, option C, 104 mm of Hg, option D, 110 mm of Hg, option E, 125 mm of Hg. Here the answer is quite straightforward and a value to be remembered, which is 104 mm of mercury or Hg. Our next question is, the exchange of gases in the alveoli of the lungs takes place by, option A, osmosis, option B, simple diffusion, option C, passive transport, and option D, active transport. Your osmosis refers to the movement of water under a gradient from higher to lower concentration. Passive transport is the movement of molecules without an external source of energy, without energy, while active transport is a process which consumes energy. However, the answer to this question is simple diffusion, as the exchange of gases in alveoli of the lungs takes place by simple diffusion. Question is, pyruvic acid is converted into a compound before formation of oxaloacetic acid in the citric acid cycle. This compound is option A, acetyl-CoA, option B, acetoacetic acid, option C, lactic acid, and option D, cis-aconitic acid. So the answer to this question is option A. Under aerobic condition, pyruvate is converted into acetyl coenzyme A and CO2 is released. Acetyl coenzyme A combines with oxaloacetic acid and forms citric acid at a later stage. So the answer to this question is option A. Hb or hemoglobin is, options are A, reproductive pigment, B, respiratory pigment, C, carbohydrate, D, fat. Here we need to remember that hemoglobin is a respiratory pigment which has the capacity of combining with oxygen molecules to form oxyhemoglobin, and each molecule of hemoglobin can combine with 4 O2 molecules, 4 oxygen molecules, and thus it is a respiratory pigment. Question is, oxygen is transported to every cell of the body through option A, RBC, option B, WBC, option C, RBC and WBC, option D, RBC and hormones. So here we need to remember the RBCs or the red blood corpuscles or the red blood cells are alone enough to transport oxygen to each and every cell of the body through blood. And do not need help from WBCs or the white blood corpuscles and hormones to perform the function. So answer over here is option A, RBCs. Next question is, respiratory system is derived from A, ectoderm, B, mesoderm, C, endoderm, and D, none of these. This is quite a straightforward answer, and to be remembered that endoderm is what the respiratory system is derived from. Next question is, body tissues obtain O2 or oxygen from oxyhemoglobin because of its dissociation caused by option A, low O2 concentration, option B, low CO2 concentration, option C, low O2 and high CO2 concentration, and option D, high CO2 concentration. So here the body tissues obtain oxygen from oxyhemoglobin because of its dissociation caused by low O2 and high CO2 concentration. A low O2 concentration being low, or low CO2 concentration or high CO2 concentration, cannot contribute to the dissociation of O2 from oxyhemoglobin. Both low high CO2 concentration and low O2 concentration is what is needed. Also, we need to remember about oxyhemoglobin that it is formed by the combination of hemoglobin, which is a respiratory pigment, with oxygen, and has capacity to combine with 4 molecules of oxygen per molecule of hemoglobin. Option is option C. Of the following, the one which is an example of buffer system in blood is option A, hemoglobin and oxyhemoglobin, option B, oxygen and carbon dioxide, option C, albumin and globulin, option D, sodium bicarbonate and carbonic acid. So here the answer is quite straightforward, that sodium bicarbonate and carbonic acid are the ones which are examples of buffer system in blood. Here we need to remember that a buffer is a solution which helps to maintain the pH of a particular mixture as per the requirement, and sodium bicarbonate and carbonic acid play the roles of buffer in our body, our blood. So the answer is option D. Our next question is, respiration is a physiological process in which option A, breathing occurs, option B, breathing and external respiration occurs, option C, breathing, external respiration and cellular respiration occur, option D, only inspiration occurs. So here we should not mistake can respiration should not be mistaken as only breathing or only external respiration or only cellular respiration. Respiration is a process which is a combination of all the three, that is breathing, external respiration and cellular respiration. So our answer to this question is option C. When the affinity of O2 and CO2 for hemoglobin pair, it is option A, more for CO2, option B, more for O2, option C, equal for both, option D, have no affinity at all. So here we need to remember that oxygen has more affinity to combine with hemoglobin to form oxyhemoglobin, and this property is essential for the proper transport of oxygen to various parts of the body through the blood or through the RBCs, and therefore answer to this question is more for oxygen. When mediating the reaction of Krebs cycle during cellular respiration in animals is found in option A, cytoplasm, option B, ribosome, option C, lysosome, and option D, mitochondria. So here the answer to the question is quite straightforward, which is the mitochondria. We need to remember that the mitochondria supplies energy in the form of ATP, which is needed for respiratory processes, and therefore the mitochondria is known as the powerhouse of a cell. Our next question is, during inspiration, the diaphragm, option A, relaxes to become dome shaped, option B, contracts and flattens, option C, expands, option D, shows no change. So here, during inspiration, it is necessary that the pressure inside the lungs is lower as compared to the pressure in the atmosphere. In order to achieve this condition, the diaphragm contracts, which increases the volume of the lungs or the pulmonary system, which leads to a decrease in the pressure in the lungs, thereby helping to fulfill the condition which is needed for inspiration. Thus, answer to this question is contracts and flattens. Question is, daily respiratory activities are controlled by option A, cerebellum, option B, cerebrum, option C, medulla oblongata, option D, diencephalon. Here the medulla oblongata of the brain has a specific region known as the respiratory rhythm center, which is responsible to control activities related to respiration, and thus our answer to this question is option C, medulla oblongata. Our next question is, how many ATP molecules are produced in Krebs cycle? Option A, 36, option B, 38, option C, 40, and option D, 24. The answer to this question is quite straightforward, which is 24, and it is important that we remember this value. Our next question is, ascent of high mountains may cause altitude sickness in men. The prime cause of this is option A, excess of CO2 in blood, option B, decreased efficiency of hemoglobin, option C, decreased partial pressure of oxygen, and option D, decreased proportion of oxygen in air. So the answer to this question is decreased partial pressure of oxygen.